I was like, damn, man.
Budweiser Canada, one of our sponsors. Quick plug.
I always worked on getting better at something, Bugsy. Unlike you. You're just content. See, this is what I did, carrying every bag grocery mail. I just crawl and get my pipes ripped. I just pick girls up and make love to them. But that's what I said, Bugsy, what are you, are you doing workouts or something? He's like, well, I don't need to do abs because I just consider fucking my ab workout. That's perfect. What do you want for breakfast, Bugsy?
Let's go. I don't care.
You want an omelet?
I'm really easy now.
Hey, look what I got. Look what I got. Where are they? Pop-Tarts.
Those things legit make your penis small.
Little bites. Dude, but actually, like, you'll be surprised. I got fruit. I got avocados. The only problem.
Well, no. Hey, she didn't charge us for the avocados because she said they're not. She said they're not good to eat.
My question was, how do you know when an avocado is good to eat?
She's like, yeah. She's like, I'm not charging.
No, you look at the top and it's really dark brown. It's brown on the inside.
I'm cutting this open. I mean, it feels fine to me. It feels nice and soft, Bugsy, like your stomach.
So they were just like, you can keep those?
Well, the guy said to me, he goes, I go, how do you know what's good? How do you know when an avocado is good? And the guy's like, he didn't answer me. He just goes, oh, this one's good. So instead of me being like, but what, you know, that still doesn't help me when I'm going to the grocery store moving forward. But then the girl said that he's weren't good.
She charged us for one of them, I think. And she said one was good. One
didn't slice that thing.
All right.
Are you gonna put that on it?
I could slice my finger off trying to cut this thing open.
What are you looking for?
The knives.
They're over here.
Oh. Thanks for the help, Dana. You're the only guy looking out for me. If this isn't good, we're going back to that Ralph's. Thought it was a well-run store, though. Shout out to Granelli. I go, you go pay for the stuff. I'll get Starbucks. What do you want? He goes, can I get a white chocolate mocha espresso, please?
And it's absolutely fire.
Oh, are you kidding me? This guy said those weren't good. I mean, the girl said we can't eat those.
Pretty good to me.
Because that's
a perfect avocado. This one might be the old busted up. This is Bugsy's career at the end, the busted up avocado. This one's good.
See, what matters on the inside. See, that's what matters on the inside.
Dude, it's all about what's on the inside. This one looks great too. Now I opened up both of them. We don't need them. So who? I'm cooking. What do you want? I need an order.
What does it look like? It looks like you're just going to put some milk in it.
Dry food.
Hey, I'll tell you right now, this house is on the market for like $3 million. How the fuck, like, how do you open the fridge?
Hold on.
Yeah, come on, dude. Who doesn't want just a handle to pull the fridge
open? Because you just push it with your hips or whatever.
Hold on.
Why are you being
first hit I've ever thrown.
No, it's just this.
This is like how I played defense. I couldn't even open the fridge up with one of my hits.
Box out from the net.
Oh my god, those practices are fun. Bugsy was the guy who, like, you'd have to practice against him. He tries so hard to be like grunting in front of the net. You never took it easy on me.
Oh, that was you, mate.
Bugsy's the guy who's like, ugh, ugh, just like making noises so it's like he's working harder. Like the louder the player, the harder he's working. No, screw it, bring it off! Do you get that, Dana? This thing is a fucking, this is a dangerous fridge. Look at this. See?
That's bad.
Yeah,
$3 million for this house. Oh, I hope
you got it.
I'll buy the groceries, I'll cook, I'll put them away, guys, don't worry. Can we get Biz up, please? Biz!
Go wake him up.
Yeah, go wake him up.
Probably put one in his belly button.
I can't believe this.
guys thought I was beaten off.
Yeah.
No, I just catch it up on sleep. I don't know if you guys heard, but I have three jobs. I work for the NHL part-time. I work for the Arizona Coyotes, who, by the way, have been rolling lately. They took 5 of 6 points against the San Jose Sharks, who have been, I think they won 7 in a row, Pittsburgh Penguins, and now they beat the Toronto Maple Leafs in Toronto 4-2. So kiss my ass, and I'm still creating content, even in my fucking sleep. Now saying that, I will be down for breakfast. Just make sure it's ready, Cordell.
What do you want, omelet? Omelet?
Yeah, I'll take an omelet.
I'm doing live, Dana, in case I win millions. I'm leaving here. I'm fucking out. I'm quitting spitting chiclets. I'll leave you some money. I'm not leaving RA a dime. What?
Are you a grill guy?
Yeah, I'm fucking the biggest grill guy. My dad got me a grill for a move-in present when I moved into my house. And I mean, it's kind of embarrassing to say at 35 if I have no idea how to grill, but this summer I learned and I crushed the grill now. Number nine, I had 59 points 1 year. More points than Bugsy ever had in a season.
We're on the same power play. All
he did was fucking stand in front of the net. I did all the work. Bugsy said, every goal I scored, it wouldn't have happened without him lifting the D stick in front of the net. The D had nothing to do with anything.
Yes, they did. How's it going over there?
Not good.
How do you play?
How do you play? How do you play a scratch ticket? You get your numbers and you scratch off the numbers. If they match, it wins. This is the first person to ever ask, how do you play a scratch ticket?
I'm not a big gambler, so all these new gambling games are in.
Oh yeah, these new scratch tickets, they just came out. You know, they're hard to figure out. I'm one number off every time.
You think they like purposely know that before they fucking cover it with the...
You know what true degenerates do, Dana? True degenerates just scratch the bottom where it tells you if the card's a winner or not. They just go right to the winner. They don't even enjoy the rush of trying to match your number. Or in case Bugsy asks, how do you play this game? That's how you play.
Well, what's your rush level right now?
It's like Bugsy was watching cricket for the first time. How do you play this game? At Moneyline, I bet it. Points, I bet it. Second half, they covered the second half.
I told you to bet second half, and you're like, that's the stupidest bet.
No,
why would you bet stock
no,
second half? Remember
no,
I told Biz?
No.
You're 1 in 600 in the you second
exactly.
half.
Exactly, yeah. I always lose second half bets. I'm like 1 in 600. I didn't say that's a stupid bet. That was a stupid comment by you.
How much does that cost?
That was $30.
Whit went to Whole Foods. He spent all the money on the cards and came back with
Pop-Tarts.
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 And kids' cereal.
No, I got fruit. By the way, they gave us money to go to Whole Foods. Instead, I went to Ralph's and used the savings on the scratchies. The avocados were $1. Whole Foods are like $6. It's not fair.
How much do you think you dumped on scratchies in your life?
I don't know. Scratch tickets? I've probably spent like $30,000. I think of the $30,000 I've spent on the scratch tickets, I've won maybe like $1,000.
That's a stretch.
It's a rush
too.
You have to match your hat, but there's no numbers.
Maybe you're only allowed to scratch off so many.
It's cake, berry, ring, moon, hat, apple, rabbit, and I have number 53. Phil Esposito, 32, Magic Johnson, 19, Ryan Whitney, 17, wow. Wendell Clark in Toronto, 16, Darcy Hordachuk, 34, I think Curtis Joseph. Did you wear 34?
Byron Defoe.
27, Jeremy Roenick, number 1, Reggie Lemelin, I think. Number 3, Ryan Whitney in college.
Wouldn't it be ironic if I cut off my finger on this little trip and couldn't play in the golf match?
When is the golf match?
I don't know.
But it happened. Wasn't it supposed to happen?
It was supposed to happen, and then it got delayed. You know, Barstool couldn't figure out where they wanted to have it. They're just delaying the inevitable of me pounding that kid.
What happens if your driver gets a little loose, though, early on?
That's my one worry. Because if at the beginning of the round, I got one lap. Hey, first hole, if I play him and it's a little left,
and the next hole's right, and then it's two-way miss time in my head. But you know what? Then I'll just start hitting hybrid or something off the tee, Bugsy. I'll just get in the fairway. You know what Bugsy told me in Scotland? Just get it in the fairway. That's all you need to play good golf. Let me tell you something. The fact that the quarterback that we're going up against bought a Team Portnoy jumpsuit, that is a tough look for the entire Rams going into this game. He spent money on a Dave Portnoy jumpsuit. Guys, I thought you bought all of those. I go food shopping, I get to the kitchen, I unpack the food bags, bring the bags in from the house. Usually you do that for like your dad when he goes food shopping. Nope, everyone sat inside. Now I'm cooking eggs for Grinnelli, imagine that. Grinnelli should be thanking someone up above that I'm cooking him eggs right now.
How many tape-to-tape passes did this guy snap to have to cook me lunch?
I should be sitting on the couch getting breakfast cooked for me. I cook the eggs and then I like add in like the veggies. So there's, what's the guy at Barstool, the $20
chef?
I'm the $30 million chef.
And then I'd like to get an interview with him here. And then I want an interview with him and Bugsy. Upshaw's available later as well. Comrie's available. So like today's a day where we can bank a bunch of interviews.
Yeah.
We can have some pops. To me, does this seem like a better environment than that?
Biz, you ever seen the $20 chef at Barstool?
Yeah.
I'm the $30 million chef. Bugsy goes like this. He goes, how do you play that game? I go, a scratch cricket? That game? I said it was like he's watching cricket for the first time.
Isn't there one where you scratch off a certain number in order where you can't scratch them all?
No, I don't know.
Why do I have my sunglasses on inside? So you better mind me to take my shades off.
Yeah, now you got content of that. People are going to be ripping you just like they rip us for everything.
I had my sunglasses on the whole time. I think I feel like more confident cooking with my shades on. What are you laughing at, Brett?
Yeah.
Dude.
Push it.
Oh. Biz. Don't even get me going on that fridge.
I don't know why. Fucking. No, I thought maybe it was a cabinet, but then as soon as I saw it like that, I knew it was going to be a
fridge. Hey, they listed the house for $3,100, but if they got a new fridge, it'd be like $7,800. How do you have one thing to cook on in this house? One pan. Biz said it best. You Barstool people eat like sewer rats. Pizza. What else do they always have in the office? What else do you always have in there?
Oh, pizza.
No, chicken strips, chicken wings.
Always wings.
Like mixing a salad, Barstool.
We're fucking common men, dude.
That's true.
Just little kid.
Go quiet boy, Bugsy.
No, don't move him up.
Get Bugsy's cooking up the bacon, please, because he's the only person in the world who doesn't know what a scratch chicken is and can't cook bacon.
I fucking cook bacon every fucking day.
Well, what happened to that batch?
Look at the bacon you bought. Oh, I don't know what to tell you.
The bacon I bought? The old natural bacon?
Oh, that's some good bacon.
Oh, don't stop. Get your cock out of his mouth, Grinnelli.
Just think it tasted great.
Maybe I shouldn't say cock.
You say cock.
Cock's one of my favorite jokes because, like, when somebody says, like, oh, if I hadn't hit the ball foul, I would have hit a home run. You're like, oh, but if your aunt had a cock, she'd be your uncle.
Yeah. Hey, I'll see.
Look at that. That's Bugsy R.
Hold on.
Yeah, that's
hard. Oh, shit. You're still ripped.
Oh, yeah, he's still ripped. Eats healthy.
Oh,
and does jujitsu.
We're going to go from having a demographic of like 99 dudes to like 98% because we're going to get a little bit of a female push after getting his abs on there.
I can't handle the mics. Maybe you should start doing some weight training.
Hey, this black piece is the exact length of my dick. Because when I hold my dick like this, there's this much above. This is my dick.
So there you go. This worked out.
Measured my dick. It's 6 inches exactly.
Oh, really?
Exactly average.
3, 2, 1. Mine's,
we're dropping these, by
mine's
the way.
7.5, but that's with foreskin rolled up. So I'm like.
No, you're 6. No, you're 5.25 without the foreskin.
Hey, I would say I'm about, I think I'm 6.5 to 6.75.
All right, are we good?
Isn't it like? I wish it was a little thicker.
Isn't the size of this finger the width?
I don't know.
Mic check, sibilance.
Hey, you know what sucks though? Is I have the smallest, shriveliest cock when it's soft. So my biggest fear is if I were to ever get like pantsed in public and somebody were to snap a photo, or you know when like
my dick's this big when it's. No, if I don't shave my bush for a while, you can't see it.
I mean, I don't get that. Hey, mine's like just the skin part. Hey, mine's just the skin part popping out. Like,
you know, this is like, I'm just going to, yeah, you shave my bush. I'll get an extra 2 inches.
Yeah.
I wish I could include that combo.
Oh, we're in
close. Just keep them fucking close.
Why? Are they not good?
No, it's just you never keep them close.
Hey, so like, Grinnell, would this be considered close? That's perfect. Okay.
Are we good?
Is this too close?
That's too close.
Okay.
Don't eat the thing.
Shut up.
He's not. Anytime he asks you a question, he's fucking with you. There's nothing serious. What do you know about that picture? Yeah. I'd love to
know. Well, I seen it in color form. And
you said it was in the movie Cars, right?
Yeah, it is.
An animated movie?
That's an animated
sure.
movie, correct?
Yeah, that is.
So is this so Highway 66 or something?
I'm pretty sure from the looks of it, from this angle.
I could have sworn I've driven. Is that what, from LA to Vegas? What's the?
I think it's deep. I mean, it's a set. You could sit there and stare at this picture. I was enjoying it until Bugsy said it's from the movie Cars, which is an animation once again. Before then, I really enjoyed it.
For those, people can't see what we're looking at, so let's describe it. It's just like a long desert road
with an enormous mountain in the back.
Yeah. Or do you know what? Go see the movie Cars.
There's some. Is it cumulus clouds? I took meteorology in high school.
Whoa!
Talk about a job you can get away with. The hockey coach at Thayer Academy also taught meteorology,
and I took it. And I just remember one thing from class. You know when the rays are shining down through the clouds and like...
Sure.
Those are called crepuscular rays. How unbelievable is that? Every time I see them, whoever I'm with, I swear to God, some of my friends have heard me say it 15 times. Because every time I say, boys, you know that's a crepuscular ray? I'm not even trying to like be funny right now.
No, I know, but it's your one shot at like sounding intelligent.
And it's the most intelligent sounding word. If you say the word crepuscular rays, immediately people are like, this guy knows what he's talking
Holy
about.
Holy shit, you go to Harvard. It shoots out when you open it. Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
What?
The on the bottom, like look at this. What's that thing?
Oh, here we go. Bugsy doesn't know what a scratch ticket is, but he's going to explain this fridge to me.
Watch when you open it again. See this little fucking thing?
Is this being recorded?
It pushes it open. And it goes back in.
Oh, I don't
know. Oh, we learned something today.
Wait,
like,
I don't know if that's actually how it works.
He doesn't either.
It's how it works.
He doesn't either. That's my whole point.
You can't prove that. And I don't trust you based on the fact you didn't even know what a scratch ticket was.
Hey, look at this guy. Look at this guy. He's blowing the dirt into our house right now. He just went like this and ripped dirt into the house. He probably heard. He built this fridge. He's like, I fucking hear them about shitting on my fridge. Our real estate agent came dressed to perfection to be a real estate agent. That's Brett. Oh, sorry. Hey, Brett.
Got a beer.
Hey, how much is this house on the market for?
18 peg.
Where is he?
I'm sitting there watching this beer go flying in and out of here.
Well, we're just going away for 10 minutes. Or maybe an hour.
I was wondering. I was like, damn, man.
Budweiser Canada, one of our sponsors. Quick plug.
It always looks bigger in pictures.
No Biz 20 promo code for that, though.
First time in the RV, boys. What do you think?
I think it's phenomenal. Biz already called the bed. Shocker.
Holy shit.
Whoa. Whoa. These guys who haven't spent a lot of time on a bus. You gotta get ready, get that wide base, hold on to the side.
Glenn Patrick was our coach, and we used to have a sleeper bus, and the front part was kind of like this, but the seats were facing each other. There was a cooler, and Curtis Patrick, his kid, he's loading it up with waters to put them on ice to have them cold for the guys for the bus trip and, of course, after the game. Well, as he's doing this, Glenn's like, whoa, 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 whoa. He goes, let me put my beers in there. And he opens up his briefcase, and he's got 50 Natty Lights in there and one piece of paper. It was his, like, game briefcase, like, make sure he checked
just
over.
Just the lineup beer, sheet the and lineup then 15 sheet. Beers.
And he shoved those beers. This guy would, it would be a Dayton Bombers we play. I think it was, like, 2 hours away. And
15 beers about right.
Yeah, it's just, oh. He drove.
Scud said he used to come in, and he'd... Glenn Patrick would be in the hot tub. What's up, guys? Good morning.
Like the head coach.
Legend.
He's been there before everyone else.
Yeah.
Normally
you'd be out of the hot tub by then and like in your suit or your tracksuit ready for practice.
Do you know the Markstrom story from the bus?
This one's good.
Marky's story. So we had a sleeper bus from San Antonio to Oklahoma City. Played them and drove there playing them again the next day. So we're on the road from like 11:30 to what, like 7:30 in the morning. So there's sleepers, so guys shut it down. So you get to the hotel, everyone, you know, kind of wakes up once the bus stops and you hear everyone, lights turn on, and you're just so exhausted. You're going back to sleep, maybe it's 6 a.m. Everyone gets off and then noon comes, we're eating the pregame meal and someone's like, where's Marky at? Calling his room, no answer, calling his cell phone, no answer. He was so exhausted, he never woke up when we all got off the bus. And then the bus drove him, he still didn't wake up, the bus left him in a bus graveyard, and he woke up on the bus with 100 buses around him, and all he saw was fence with barbed wire, and he's like, what am I gonna do? He had to break out of the bus, and he had to throw his blanket over the barbed wire and crawl over, and he's starting the game that night, and he's on the road hitchhiking.
Did he win the game? I'd be curious to know what the stat line
was. I'm so bad at remembering results.
On the bus, though.
I'd probably remember if I had a point.
Yeah, really not sure.
That's just a joke.
Yeah, no, it's not. And you know why? Because I don't know if he told the story on the podcast or we were just shooting the shit about how when
this
you.
It's going to be the whole bus ride to San Jose, this nonsense.
Yeah, this nonsense. When you were eating McDonald's, but you didn't give a shit because the team lost because you were putting up over a point a game in playoffs.
No, I was proving. I cared we lost. I was proving that the pancakes weren't slowing me down. If anything, they were speeding me up.
Right, but you remembered specifically because you were lighting the lamp.
One day here, I've already lost my voice. One day it took. New York City, it took two.
Have you ever been, sir?
I've actually tried it once. I was brutal.
Let me tell you something. God. I know for a fact, you could give me 10 years, I wouldn't be able to stand up on that board in the water.
I feel the
same. I know for a fact, I cannot. I can barely stand up with my ankles now, like on the earth, on the ground.
Ankles are not helping you.
And so if I'm trying to get up on a board that's moving in the water, and I'm also got the thought of sharks somewhere around there, I'm not getting up on that board. I don't even think I could boogie board. I can't time a boogie board.
Take the sharks out of the equation, I'm still on his page, and I'm still so looking hard. About 10 years.
Yeah, no, it's hard.
I'd like fist fight the shark though. That's like the one thing.
You're supposed to punch a like shark in the nose. I think you're supposed to punch a shark right in the snout. The shark sees your snout. He's like, I'm going after his.
Just punch like this too.
The shark's like, oh my God, jeez, I'm supposed to get punched in the nose. Look at this dude's nose fighting me. Crazy. I don't go in the ocean anymore because of sharks. I don't step foot. I'll go up to my like knee.
You know what someone's gonna tell you?
I'm a pussy.
Yeah, you're a fear monger. Like, oh, it's like a one in a million. Oh, yeah?
Well, guess what?
I'll be that fucking.
Because I've been in a one in a million. The other one is the lanky guy who made the NHL just snap it.
Yeah, and then almost just to prove him wrong, you want to go in that water and get bit by a shark so you could be on shore bleeding to death. And you look at the guy, you're like, see the fuck I told you? You're the one in a million? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And he's like, and then he's walking away being like, geez, I guess he was right. And that's all you get out of it. And you're now missing your fucking leg.
I think you're putting yourself into the story and that's how you would be reacting. Yeah. I would just be thinking, no more golf. This is a panic attack. This guy was right. I got nothing to say to him.
Well, I'd be more concerned about proving him wrong.
I'm shooting 68. I shot 68 at the course with my father-in-law. I was so good that this day he quit after 9 holes. He's like, I just want to watch you, Ryan. I just want to watch this. Seven birdies, 3 bogeys, 4 under, and then I went back and got my feet massaged, drinking a beer, looking over the ocean. That's worth 1,800 or whatever it was.
Look how weak his ankles are. Oh, look, oh my God, oh my God, slow down.
Would you ever come here?
You see how shredded this guy is? You've seen how big this guy is?
I know, we were just talking. We were just talking about that.
This guy would suplex me.
It's quite the work to rest ratio.
I think this guy thinks he's Chris Herron.
Shit!
Hey, first to a point, guys.
I know, we're trying.
Wesley Snipes and Woody Harrelson would dummy these two. Oh! White chocolate! Hey, are we witnessing the worst basketball game of all time? This is a professional athlete. Oh my God, this. His dribbling, he's dribbling like Warren in Something About Mary.
Oh, fuck!
God. Enough is enough.
All right. We're a little more modest in hockey after victory.
Hockey.
He's just rubbing it in. You're rubbing it.
By the way, you didn't score a point for 45 minutes.
You're rubbing my face now.
I
thought it was a good match.
To get a point. Yeah. Oh, look at the cops are coming. They heard RA's in town.
Hey, what's up, gang? It was long, man. I hadn't flown to California in about 21 years. Last time I saw the Bruins play the Ducks, shout out Bees. It was 97, so I thought the flight wasn't as long as it was, but it was, you know, whatever, it is what it is. They got a sweet palace, they hooked us up. It's kind of funny, I feel like I'm at like NHL fantasy camp, hanging out with a bunch of fucking retired NHL savages, tearing it up. Probably tore it up a little too much before dinner last night, I was a little banged up. I never squeezed in that nap I had planned on, a couple edibles, you know, and you know, I took a little nap before my squid came out. Might have helped myself to someone else's food in the meantime. I was pretty hungry, but it's great so far, man. I'm looking forward to going up to Hollywood today.
Probably one of the funniest guys we've had on. Teddy
with his dog. With his dog today.
Oh yeah. Shout out to his puppy Eddie Vedder. Sorry.
Just one name. He's like Madonna, but Vedder.
You have to hold your mic up here. You should have seen Bugsy.
Literally.
Yeah, so obviously we're doing these a little bit differently. You're not on your phone calling in, so you have to keep the mic up to your mouth. Bugsy had a very difficult time doing that.
Bugsy got outsmarted by the mic again.
He's not the sharpest knife in the drawer.
Some guys just still want to play. Oh, Scotty upshot this guy here. Vedder's going nuts. Vedder loves him.
He does.
Updog, what's up, buddy? We're doing great.
Scotty upshot just showed up mid-interview.
So every time you talk, just keep it right here. Yo, boys,
rooftop.
Do you guys want to go up to the rooftop and chatter?
Sounds like it, I guess. It's a
but this is Bugsy, though. When Bugsy's not the center of attention, he's like, ugh, fuck.
Yeah, let's say, hey, you had your time to fucking ask.
No, Bugsy, once again, they're cheeking me. I don't have a microphone every time.
And she's not obviously a veteran of the golf cart and how the mechanics work, and they're holding on.
You need to hold on once in a while.
She flies out, boys, and she's like, right into the fescue. it's like trying to look for your golf ball in there.
RA and Biz are going down to the Walk of Fame. Is that what it's called? The Walk of Fame, Star of Fame. So RA's going to talk about all the movie stars he likes. Biz is going to get him going, so we'll get some content there. And then we got Mike Comrie as Bugsy's throwing stuff at me. Oh, look, I'm throwing Reese's Puffs at me. We got Mike Comrie coming. We're going to interview him later today, maybe another special guest. So we're working things out, but we're getting stuff done. We're doing some work. Stop throwing stuff at me. He's such a child.
You don't like the pops?
You can't handle the pressure?
You can't take this guy anywhere.
You can't handle the pressure.
Hey, so the movie Slapshot?
Yep.
You know the girl who Newman has sex with, and then she's got kind of like those...
Banana tits. Yeah.
That kind of got me going.
Oh, dude, oh,
like,
yeah.
It was weird. They were like a ski slope, well, but like it just like something about it. Like I call them 70s tits.
Banana titties, yeah.
Like big lips, too. Like I don't discriminate. I mean, who am I to say I have the fucking ugliest foreskin on the planet? No, I know Orlando Bloom. He's the one who's got the huge wrench who was with Katy Perry when they caught him on that paddleboard. You know he had a little Cialis in him when he was... He knew the paparazzi were around, too. You know when you see Orlando Bloom's cock?
Oh yeah, when he was on.
He's part of the huge wrench club.
Oh yeah, you definitely got to chub up, dude.
All right, write him a check.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Pablo Benici, big up yourself, man. I love you, boys, but you don't know that I'm rock stars. Pablo Benici.
He's heating up. He's heating up. Oh, there's RA's buddy. There's RA's best friend, Matt Damon. Spent 40 minutes with him.
Matt Damon, local guy. Got to give a shout out to him. Dude, everywhere you look, there's someone big. Michelle Pfeiffer, dude. Forrest Whitaker.
Let's just concentrate on Matt Damon.
All right, Matt
RA's
Damon.
RA's movie ADD is on fleek right now.
It definitely is, whatever that means. But it's staying alive.
Oh, look at... Okay, RA. Okay, baby.
Live Field, Vin Diesel, and Ivan Bogart. Yeah, let's give it a...